guys. It is 5 a.m. First day of OB. I finally made it up.
This week, I'm on antepartum and OB labor and delivery. So I'll be starting with rounds in the morning. Antepartum basically means that we're seeing pregnant moms who have been admitted for some type of complication in their pregnancy, either something going on with the mom or something going on with the baby that just requires a little bit more close watching. And after that, we'll be heading up to the OB floor where there are a number of expectant moms who could be delivering any moment. So we'll be following some of them and fingers crossed, maybe we'll see a baby delivered today. Yeah, let's get going. Okay, here we go. It is quiet and it is dark, but thank you guys for joining. Hey everyone, just got out of a whirlwind day in the hospital. As you can see, it's dark again. We don't get a lot of sunlight here in these winter months. You know, I wish it were possible to show you more of what goes on in the hospital, but as you know, patient privacy is extremely important, and so is being sensitive to the fact that when they're in the hospital, they're in a really vulnerable place. So when I get home, I'll give you a Reader's Digest version of what went on, what we got to see, whether or not I saw a delivery. But first things first, as medical students, it's often really hard to get a good meal in. We get really used to eating protein bars and 30-second lunches. So today's a treat because some classmates and I are gonna be making some chicken parm sandwiches. It's gonna be delicious, so food first and thoughts later.
Parm time.
What time is it, Arjun?
For real?
Yo, I got something in these. Holy sh**.
They're so good, right?
Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy.
Watch the sunset, kinda. Yeah, yeah. Rolling eyes back in my head, make my toes curl. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, yummy.
Yo, this actually looks bomb, bro.
You're incriminating, no disguise. And you ain't never running low on supplies. 50-50, love the way you split it. 100 racks on me, spin it, babe.
Hey everyone, made it back home. Today was my first day on labor and delivery, and it was amazing and mind-blowing. I saw 4 deliveries today, 3 C-sections, 1 vaginal birth, and it was just one thing after the next as the next. So got in around 6:45 when the team is signing out. And what that means is the night team is telling the day team what happened overnight and kind of what things to look out for. And there are a few categories of patients that we look at on labor and delivery. So there's
antepartum, which is moms who have any type of complication that, you know, we're worried about that we want to track. And then we have postpartum, which is mothers who have stayed overnight that we're watching for whatever reason. And then there is labor and delivery. So this is where moms come in when they are in labor, their water is ruptured, you know, they had a planned C-section, and they are imminently going to deliver. The resident works with us to give us any number of patients on this big board. Started the day out actually following a patient. They had what's called arrest of descent, which means that she's pushing and pushing, but the baby wouldn't come out. And so what we do next is a C-section. I mean, a C-section is just kind of mind-blowing. I mean, you make an incision into the abdomen, you see the fat layers, the fascia, the muscles, and then you see the uterus. And then they cut into the uterus, and I mean, the first thing you see is this. It's almost like one of those stress balls that kind of blow up when you squeeze them, and sometimes there's glitter inside and there's, like, you know, the proteins basically swirling around, and they'll push down on the stomach and they'll pop the amniotic sac. It's kind of what happens when the water breaks normally in pregnancy. And there's this massive gush of fluid. I mean, it can go everywhere. And then immediately the resident's hand goes in, takes the baby by the bottom of its head and starts pulling. And then, I mean, it's just crazy. You know, next thing you know, there's a baby and you're, you know, rubbing it, trying to make it cry, cutting the umbilical cord. It's a million things happening at once. And then, you know, you show the baby to the mom and to the dad who's also in the room. And then you, you know, hand it off to the nurses. And so, it's just absolutely crazy. And then, you know, I left the C-section. I was following another patient who was going to have a vaginal delivery. She had her epidural in, her contractions were starting, and we just had her push. And after two or three pushes, the baby was delivered. The resident had me in there delivering the placenta afterwards. You know, we massage the uterus, try to get it to contract back down. And eventually the placenta just kind of falls out, and we're, you know, kind of lightly twisting it to make sure that it comes out in one piece, because what we don't want is the placenta to be partly retained in the uterus, because that can bleed a lot. The placenta is basically a highway of blood vessels from the mom to the baby. And if that highway is kind of left in there, you know, there's a lot of bleeding that can happen. So that birth happened really, really quickly. Another C-section, planned C-section this time. The mom had an abdominal cerclage that was put in. The cervix can sometimes get prematurely dilated, and that can be really dangerous to the baby. And they had put a tie around the cervix to keep it shut so that it physically could not open. And so because it was physically shut, the mom just couldn't do a vaginal delivery. So we had to do a C-section. That C-section went very smoothly, just as planned. After that C-section, there was one other patient that I was following who was also meant to have a vaginal delivery. It was her first child. I mean, she was a trooper. I mean, she had been pushing and pushing for 3 hours, and her water had been broken for almost 24 hours. We were past the 18-hour threshold for what we consider prolonged rupture of membranes. And so if the water has been broken for too long, it gives a way for bacteria to go in and cause infections. And that puts both the baby and the mom at risk. And so, you know, she really wanted to deliver vaginally, and we had a few nurses in there trying different methods. You always hear about how painful birth is and contractions and pushing. But I don't, you know, I will never truly understand what that feels like. You know, just seeing how hard she was working, and, you know, it's not just the pain, but it's the endurance of the pain as well. Nonstop going on, and it was just excruciating. She had just kind of reached a point where she couldn't do it anymore. It was just really hard for her. You know, she really did not want to have a C-section, was really, really scared about having surgery, and she was really worried about the pain. And, you know, the nice thing about being a medical student is you have the time to just talk to patients, and, you know, as you see more of these procedures, you kind of get a sense of what to expect and what a patient can expect. It felt really cool to be able to talk to her and kind of answer some of her questions about what it would feel like, whether or not she would feel pain, what we do to make sure that she doesn't feel pain, and what she can do and what she should avoid after the C-section. Just, you know, talking to the patient really goes a long way when you're a med student, and one of the things that feels a little bit more fulfilling. But we took her back, did a C-section, no complications whatsoever. She had a beautiful baby girl, handed her right off to mom and dad in the operating room, finished that surgery around 6 o'clock, and yeah, a whirlwind of a day, a lot of different cases, and 4 birthdays to remember. So yeah, I mean, it's Monday, it's the beginning of the week, it's my first day. I mean, it's just absolutely crazy. Hope it was useful or interesting to learn a little bit more about what a med student does when they're on labor and delivery. I certainly had no idea going in what to expect. So that was my day. Anyway, guys, thanks for tuning in. This is my first vlog, just an idea that I wanted to pursue at the beginning of this year. Yeah, I mean, I hope you guys enjoy it. I mean, I'm really doing this because I had my surgery rotation and it just flew by. And you know, there's not really a lot of time to process and stop and think about what's going on. And I really wanted the way to do that a little bit more. Clerkship is amazing. It's a time where we go from being students and thinking like students who primarily are evaluated by taking tests to being care providers. You know, it's just an incredible experience. If you guys want to see more videos like this, be sure to comment below, like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Yeah, I'm just cruising, you just losing, gotta make a meal before I lose it. I'm just cruising, you just losing, gotta make a meal before I lose it.